name is Charlotte Stirling-Reed and I'm the baby and child nutritionist. I'm super excited to be teaming up with Mother and Baby today to answer all your questions when it comes to how to introduce solid foods to your baby. Now, I'm super lucky at the moment because I'm actually going through the weaning journey with my little one, who is about 6.5 months. And I've been showing that a lot on social media and getting lots and lots of positive feedback about parents who are a bit anxious about how to start. So really, this video is all about helping you get over that first hurdle, giving you tips, advice, and answering plenty of your questions. So join on with us and I'll be showing you all about how to wean this one. So one of the questions that people asked me was, what was the very first food I gave to my children? Now, I have two children. I have Raffi, who's 3.5 years old, and I have Ada, who is just 6 months, and she's just started the weaning journey herself. Both of them started their weaning journey off with broccoli, and honestly, it's still one of Raffi's favourite foods now, and Ada is absolutely loving having broccoli in her diet. So Ada's definitely a huge fan of broccoli. Yeah, it's really easy to cook it, so it's nice and soft. If you look at that, it squidges really easily between my finger and thumb and it just flakes off. And that's exactly what happens when baby takes it and has it in baby's mouth. It's also really readily available. It's also fairly inexpensive and it's just a really great finger food option for baby. Of course, you can offer it as a puree and you can mix it in with plenty of other foods for babies after their first taste. So broccoli is definitely something that Ada is really familiar with. I find it's a really super simple side to offer her when I'm offering her a different meal that day. Nice, Ada. So when it comes to what food to introduce to your little ones first, I'm a massive advocate of veg-led weaning. And this is essentially where you start your baby off with their weaning journey with a variety of different tastes of veggies. So a new veggie each day for around about 1 or 2 weeks of weaning. And the concept behind this is basically that babies are born with a preference for sweet foods. They don't need much help to enjoy something like an apple or a pear puree, but actually they do need a little bit of a nudge in order for them to be able to accept more savory and bitter taste that you get from vegetables. So for example, if you're starting off your weaning journey with veg and offering baby a single taste of veggies each day, and then when you start to build more variety into your baby's diet, continuing to offer plenty of veggies alongside that variety, this has actually been shown in research to help little ones accept the taste of vegetables later on in life. So veg-led weaning is something I really am a big fan of and something I started with my own little ones too. Now, when it comes to weaning, I actually recommend that you start with vegetables and that you offer single tastes of veggies for the first 10 days or so of weaning. And ideally offering plenty of variety in that time, but this just helps babies to get used to a totally new taste that they've never had before. Babies are very used to sweet flavours in their diet because they've had it via the amniotic fluid and they've also had it via breast milk or formula milk. And actually what we want to do when we start off the weaning journey is introduce them to something totally new that they've never tasted before. So my concept is to offer 10 days or so of single taste of veggies and plenty of variety before moving on to offer a really wide variety of other foods. What do you think of that, Ada? Is that nice water, darling? Is that nice water? The other thing to add is that during the weaning journey, you really don't expect baby to be eating and gobbling up much, especially in those early days. So this is about letting them get tiny tastes of this food into their mouth. It's about them experiencing new textures and what it feels like and learning to self-feed. So if they're not getting huge amounts in at the start of weaning, try not to worry too much. We know that they're going to be getting plenty via their milk, plenty of energy and nutrients, and really the food is a top-up at the very start of weaning. When it comes to weaning, people are often worried about what foods they need to avoid during the weaning journey. And actually, when baby gets to around 6 months of age, there's not many foods that are on the list of foods to avoid. However, there are some that the NHS very clearly state, and these include foods such as sugar and salt, and foods that contain sugar and salt. These should be left off the menu as long as possible, really. The other foods this includes is foods such as choking hazards, so whole grapes and whole nuts. These should not be offered to baby, and whole grapes and whole nuts should not be offered to baby till at least 5 years of age. On top of that, honey is not recommended till baby is at least 1 year of age. There are also some certain cheeses and certain fish that baby should not have in their diet, and also rice drinks are also not recommended for young children. So after your little one has had those single taste of veggies, it's really about building plenty of variety into your little one's diet. It's about moving them on to what we call family foods nice and gradually throughout their weaning journey. So after their single taste, you can start to build in new tastes. Say, for example, you might add things like beans and lentils and pulses in small amounts. You also might add things like meat and fish, and you also might add things like carbohydrates like pasta and potato and rice to your baby's diet. Now you can offer these in however way you prefer. You can mash them up into their meals, or you can offer things like pasta and bread as finger foods to your baby. It's totally up to you how you prefer to do that, but ultimately it's about building in that variety. Start with a couple of combinations, so broccoli and potato, and then you might start to move to broccoli and potato with some flavours, maybe some herbs or spices in there. And then you might start to create what we call mini meals, where you're thinking about building in things like proteins, carbohydrates and vegetables into most of baby's mealtimes. So this is a really nice gradual process, but ultimately you want to think about A, variety, what kind of variety can I get into my little one's diet, and B, what kind of meals am I having, and try and incorporate some of your meals into your own baby's meals too. So when it comes to building on variety, you can absolutely start to offer herbs and spices to your little one. Now the best herbs and spices to offer are the ones that you have generally as a family. I would definitely say stay clear of things like cayenne pepper or chili, at least until your baby is one. But when it comes to all herbs and spices, it's a good idea to start with a really small amount and build up gradually. And definitely use the ones that you tend to use in your own cooking at home. So some of my tips for trying to make those mealtimes easier and smoother, I know that weaning can be a really anxious time for lots of families. So some of my tips for making it a little bit smoother include, number one, try and bring baby to the table with you. Let baby see you eating. Let baby experience that process of being at the table and being around food from a really early age, even before they start the weaning journey. Number two, I would say try and eat similar foods to your baby. Actually, the more that your baby sees you eating and sees you eating the foods that you want your little one to eat, the more likely they are going to be to accept those foods. Number three, think variety. So after those first taste of foods, think about how to build plenty of variety into your little one's diet, because actually research shows that the more variety children have when they're younger, the more variety they are likely to have when they are older. And number four, I always like to think about fridge-raid meals. It can be really difficult to constantly be thinking about what do I need to feed the kids, what do I feed my baby, but actually sometimes I think it's a really great idea to have a look in your fridge, see what needs using up, and just try and balance those meals out. So as long as you're offering something like a carbohydrate, a protein, and a vegetable at that meal, you're probably ticking off all those food groups that you need to be offering. So have a look at what needs using up, make something for baby and for you that you can share together. So some of my five must-have products when it comes to the weaning journey are, number one, a really good bib. There is going to be a lot of mess. Sorry, but there is. Number two, a really good blender that allows you to blend small amounts of food if you need to. You don't need a blender for very long, but actually even when baby's a lot older, it still can be very useful for making soups and sauces and other dishes like that. Number three, a soft tip spoon. It's a really good idea to offer your baby a nice soft spoon that they can chew, that they can actually move around in their mouth. This can really help them with all the muscle movements and help them get used to the process of eating as well as biting and chewing, and soft spoons can be really, really handy for that. Number four, a high chair. A high chair is really essential, and it's a good idea to go for a high chair that has a little footrest for your baby so that they can sit nice and upright in their high chair. And number five, of course, is my book, which is called How to Wean Your Baby. So thank you so much for joining us. I hope you enjoyed that, and I hope that those tips were helpful to you. I've got plenty more over on my website and on my social channels, but I really want to let you know that my book, which is called How to Wean Your Baby, has everything you need to know about introducing solid foods to your little one from the very start right till they're on family foods. And it is everything. So it covers textures, it covers finger foods, there's also plenty of recipes in there, and there's lots of helpful infographics to help parents understand things like how much milk should they offer, when should they be moving from one meal to two meals to three meals a day. Everything is very much a guidance and a handheld step-by-step guide throughout that weaning journey, including a step-by-step guide through the first 30 days. So I really hope that will be helpful to you, and I just want to say thank you so much for listening.